rainy afternoon.
They say sleep early and recover late, then you will have a great day. Exactly a good idea to have something, a soft drink, right? What if you just work out? It's best to have fun. You should maybe have fun. Something warm, and a cup of coffee, or probably some warm milk. But anyway, after a long day of just wake up and seeing the beautiful day made by the early morning. How's the scenery looks like? Just like how you can see in the scenery right now, I'm actually feeling a bit tired and such. Whereby I even show my somewhat tired expression. So anyway, I hope you enjoy that. And moving on, I'm going to rock that particular day where we actually go for this outing in the pool. So right before we actually go for this outing, I did want to talk about what actually happened the day before today. Bye-bye. Special effects, and that's where the great afternoon came, where I actually thought that things cannot get you any more better, and just somehow get even better. Get if you have this beautiful rainy afternoon where it's actually very relaxing. It doesn't really make me feel like actually like to just go to bed, sleep in, as it's actually pretty cool and chilly. So is there a good day? I suppose it depends from one person to another. So regarding to the trolling, what we first have to do is that we need to travel to Bukit Bintang, or in this case me have to travel to Bukit Bintang. which is actually having, we actually have this trouble to that location where we want to explore that particular location. Then in the previous video, I did show that we did head over to this pavilion mall and also head over to this sukiya, or you can eat hot pot area, where in my perspective is that it's the best place that I actually like, because that time I'm craving for meat, so I actually enjoy it. But after that, the next destination we are going to travel to is actually to Mutiara Damansara. Now that's actually a whole new different location. And during that time, since that is our actual, let's just say, next travel, or our next exploration destination. Now what, when I think that after the beautiful rainy day, or beautiful rainy afternoon, rainy season, well, anyway you want to call it, so I thought that things couldn't get any better. During the time when we are at this, if around our travel, there's this rainy season as well, and it's actually very refreshing. But things cannot get any better when we actually have to travel all the way to Mutiara Damansara, whereby we actually left out from the main group, which have already left us and travel over to their destination. Now, they left us and travel to the destination. Just kidding. Anyway, this is in life when we have something to go through, right? When we actually have to travel to a specific destination or to explore a new location, we always have these challenges where we have to face. But all these challenges is what making it interesting. Exploration in life, where you explore a lot of things, whether it's new, whether it's what we see is also exploratory. But so since there's I have to go because the teardrums are this is actually a new challenge. It's actually a challenge that then you by if you are able to actually overcome this challenge, you will actually have this sense of satisfaction when you actually have So you see, when you actually in life, right, you will meet various challenges, and if you don't give up and you manage to overcome them, you'll be able to have this great sense of satisfaction that after you have overcome them and actually feel like you have actually achieved something. So basically, it's just like similar to a game, because in life, it's either same or similar to that of an, let's say, it's similar or same as game, except that it doesn't have, like what I actually said just now, it's just that in life, it doesn't have a just same point where you can act as a, you know, a starting point where you can start over again from that particular set point. Although it's not exactly or rather not as easy, I would say you can, but I would say you can as well. Maybe if you feel that it doesn't agree with this, or maybe you agree with this, that's probably something for you to ponder about. So this time, when I think of this diagram, it's actually very far away and you look at the room and then you look at the room and yeah, so far away, I actually thought that this is actually my challenge that is much greater. So, yes, literally it's greater, but whether it's that great that I couldn't actually use a better method, which is a much more easier method where I can actually draw while crawling, I can actually take a look at the scenery around this kind of things. It's not by, of course you can, there's always an option of taking a taxi or for example, yeah, let's just say take a taxi to reach your destination, but the thing is, you know, with taxi, sometimes you just unable to see the better scenery of the surrounding room. So, in my own method is that I usually like to take something like a public transport or rather transit and such, so that I can actually take a better view of the surrounding. From one place to another. So yeah, I actually thought I made a greater challenges this time. So during that time I couldn't find a way to actually reach the destination at first. Aside with the huge round bar. Yeah, aside from the visual about that is suggested by Google Maps to reach the destination whereby I have to. If you are looking at this picture currently right now, you'll be able to see I have to take the MRT, then change to another transit and go back to take another MRT again, which is also, I'd say it's a train to reach to our destination. That's a huge roundabout and it takes roughly 1 hour and 20 minutes. Around that 1 hour to 2 hours. 2 hours plus. So it's not exactly a very good idea to take such a huge roundabout. And so I'm thinking that there must be a better way. There must be a better way. So that's until I remember something during that time. Then I actually saw something that I actually saw. That I actually remember. Now, there are two key points here. First is that I could, there's an MRT station in Japan. That is where our first traveling destination is, and also our first exploration location is. This is the first key point. Second key point is that MRT, this train, or at least transit maybe, this MRT actually can reach to our second destination, which is Mutiara Damansara. So now, since I got this to keep on, it raised my curiosity. Since MRT can actually reach to the that particular destination, my curiosity led me to walk further into the road path of the MRT transit or train. What is actually the route of all the what on what station does MRT stop at? Actually have stop at, or where is their train, each of the MRT train station is located. So I have to look further into the map, which is belongs entirely to the MRT train station. MRT to look at their roadmap, and then I realized that I can actually I actually got my answer. So since I already got my answer, that's the third point. The third point is that I can reach to the destination. The curiosity which will lead to my third point, whereby is that what is the travel road map of the MRT train station, or where is the train station of located, where do they actually stop at? What are their number of stops? Where is their train location set? So there's a third point. Since it led to me to the third point, it allowed me to get an idea of it. So what I did is just further look into it. Then I got my answers. Yep. Then I got my answers. So what is left after that is there for me to travel to that specific location. Or what I did like to put it as, it's time to embark on a journey. Wait, journey? Oh no. Ah yes. It's time to embark on a journey. Or exploration. So yeah, oh by the way, my smartphone during that time when we are actually traveling, it happens to run out of power. Why does it have to
ってもらおう。
ここで写真撮ってない。Okay. Anyway, it can be out soon. It's actually quite unfortunate that you actually run out of power. So, yeah, you run out of power. This one I can tell you is that the scenery along the way of our traveling, in that from Bukit Bintang all the way to Jalan Darmansara, it's actually quite. The scenery is actually quite beautiful, and although I am unable to take the picture of it, but if any of you guys actually is in the area, right, you can actually, if you ever happen to take the MRT train station, which is from Bukit Bintang, which is KL area, Kuala Lumpur, travel all the way to Mutiara Damansara, I can say around there, which is located at Selangor, then you probably will be able to observe the scenery and maybe you did actually like it. I did say Selangor, this particular state have a pretty good nature, whereby they keep their nature very well. It's actually very beautiful, although there are still a lot of huge supermarket, and the technology is also very pretty well. I'd say it's pretty much comparable to that in KL, but in Selangor, the state is actually much better due to the nature, the scenery look better as well. So yeah, that's basically it. So it's actually very beautiful. Still, how they are running out of battery at such an important time. Oh well, I guess it can be out. So anyway, of course, by the time we reached the MIT station, of course, by the time we actually reached to the MIT station, of course, by the time we reached the exploration, we found out that Jalan Damansara Hotel is actually close by, which is at the north side of the Cove Mall. It seems like it's attached, or rather it's connected just with a single doorway heading, and you can head in the hotel, which is, I did say, is pretty unique, as the curve is actually divided into the building. It's actually like divided into two, and in the middle is are actually connected with different shop blocks and buildings. Also different. There are a lot of hawker stores around there. Although I won't really call it as hawker stores. But more onto accessories, something like a tourist, something that tourists would buy them. But the curve, which direct into both north and south, is actually into two different modes. Actually, it's not very far, it's close by, so it's actually pretty interesting with the design. The other move that I have actually been to, so it's actually quite interesting. The window I wanted to ask you, is it? Although the mall, within the mall itself, the curve mall, yeah, I did call it. It's actually quite a lot of shop inside, which maybe I will show you about that later on in another video, which coming up later on. We will see about that, but not included in this video. I think I didn't really record much in there, but I hope I did. So anyway, so moving along, so we did discover a lot of things and such. And of course along the way we did discover that the shopping, there are also a few like hawker store whereby they did sell their chicken wings and such, quite a few of them that did sell some pretty delicious food. So that's along the way before we actually reach to our destination, or I'd say our meetup point, which is at Warrior Chulan Damansara Hotel. I thought that's actually a pretty interesting hotel, I'd say. In a way, it's pretty interesting. I thought, I'd say the design is pretty good. It's actually pretty good. And I wish you, if you want to know about houses, best to get an idea how it actually looks like, it will be in the next coming up video, which I'm going to I will be editing, but not on this one. So yeah, just stay tuned. And yeah, see, I already thought the mall is actually quite unique, but there's another after the mall. Like we did head to after that, behind the mall there's this place called, there's in the coast by that there's actually this shopping mall called Tesco. Yeah, Tesco. It's actually a Tesco supermarket whereby we could travel inside and yeah, you know, people buy to just all their grocery and such. For me it's that after Tesco there's also other one called IKEA, where it's actually for people to mainly to purchase furniture. But the special part in this area is that instead of just selling furniture, they attract the customer by selling food and as well, and also doing this the food court. They also host also have a section where it's their own food court. Now that food court is actually pretty interesting because from the way they direct their customer to travel along the road, whereby the customer travel into the Royal, the IKEA market, if some of them happen to not purchase, not be aiming, looking into what IKEA is trying to sell to their customers, instead their customer go for food, their customer will be directed to the food court whereby they will have their lunch or dinner or whatsoever. After it turn, they will have another different road where usually customers will just go on a different road if they are new to the location. So that will actually direct the customer back into their shopping mall. That whereby in their shopping mall to show what they actually sells there to somehow like make the customer actually to buy something from IKEA. Although technically the food court is already belongs to IKEA, so there's actually quite a play being played there. I didn't really manage to tell a video about that, and I also forgotten about it, requesting for the photo from one of the group members. But then again, that's just a rough idea to share about, as this kind of tactic actually being implemented in various Western countries, such as probably in the US side or American side, they have already such a tactics going on, as from what I actually saw it on YouTube and such. And I'm pretty sure Australia as well, because most of the goods from IKEA is actually from, a lot of them are imported from Australia, so I'm assuming that they may have get the strategy, the idea of this strategy from Australia or any Western Western-like country, I just said Westernized country, such as America, Britain, and or New Zealand and such. Kobe is around there because a lot of goods is imported. So anyway, that's about it. So I guess that's the end. Video is about.